Hello children, today we are going to discuss about petroleum. First we will discuss origin of petroleum. Petroleum is believed to have formed over a period of millions of years from organisms that lived in the sea at that time. When these organisms died, their bodies settled on the seabed and got covered with sand and clay. Over millions of years, due to heat and pressure changed the dead organism into petroleum hydrocarbons. As you know, animal body contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and all, like plants, okay? So, change the dead organism into petroleum hydrocarbons. Now, occurrence. Petroleum and natural gas are often found together as large deposits deep inside the earth crust. Petroleum is obtained by drilling through the earth and impervious means non-porous rocks above it. The world's first oil well to yield petroleum was dug in Pennsylvania, USA in 1859. In India, oil is obtained from oil wells in Assam, Gujarat, Bombay High, in the deltas of the rivers Godavari and Kaveri. And other places are also there where we get this petroleum. The crude oil pumped out from a well is a black color liquid. So children, that is why we also call it black coal. Okay? Because of its color, and it is very expensive, or we can say it is very useful. That is why we call it black coal. Now, after getting this black liquid or crude oil, what we do, how do we get different components from the crude oil? That is called refining of petroleum. Here I have drawn fractionating tar. Refining takes place in this fractionating tar. So what principle we keep in our mind during refining, and what is fractional distillation, I am going to tell you. The crude oil contains various hydrocarbons. Okay, the various hydrocarbons present in petroleum have different boiling points. So many hydrocarbons are present and their boiling points are different. As the number of carbon atoms in the hydrocarbon increases, its boiling point also increases. Like I am giving you example, this is methane, it has one carbon atom. Ethane, it has two carbon atom. So this way, when the carbon atom increases, its boiling point also increases. So this thing we have kept in mind for fractional distillation. As we know, there are number of hydrocarbons. So again I am repeating, as the number of carbon atoms in hydrocarbon increases, its boiling point also increases. This property is used to separate the different components of petroleum by fractional distillation method. Okay, first what we do, we take crude oil. This process takes place in refineries. One of the refineries, Mathura refinery, and there are so many refineries are there. So it is this process carried out in petroleum refinery. Here, crude oil is first heated to about 400 degree Celsius in a furnace. This is furnace. The vapors formed are passed into tall fractionating tar. This is fractionating tar. The hydrocarbon with the highest boiling point condense first. Like according to boiling point they are going up, which is having highest boiling point, it condense first here. Okay. The hydrocarbon with 1 to 4 carbon atom, which are gases, do not condense and escape from the top of the tar, and we call that petroleum gas. Okay. Some important petroleum fraction and their uses I am going to discuss. First is LPG, and we also call it liquid petroleum gas. what is the use of LPG? Fuel for home, and this is fuel for home and industry. Second is gasoline and naphtha. From this we get petrol. Petrol is used for motor fuel, aviation fuel, solvent for dry cleaning. Okay, and then I am going to tell you about like light oil. Light oil, diesel comes. Diesel, fuel for motor vehicle, especially heavy vehicles, and electric for electric generator. Then we will come to heavy oil. It is useful for organic chemicals. And then residue, what is left behind? Okay, what is left behind? That is what? Residue. That residue is also very useful. It is used like lubricating oil we get from residue. Residue means leftover, as I told you. Lubricating oil is used for lubricating machinery, paraffin wax for making candles, Vaseline ointment, etc. Asphalt is used for making paints and road surfaces, and asphalt is also called bitumen. So children, this is about petroleum. Now uses of petroleum. Okay, all you know that just now we have discussed uses. It is mainly used for fuel and making so many other things. Come to the natural gas. Natural gas is found along with petroleum in reservoir under the ground. It is chiefly made up of methane. Now I am going to tell you about natural gases. Okay. Along with petroleum, we get it. Okay. Natural gas is found along with petroleum in reservoirs. Under the ground, it is chiefly made up of methane, propane, butane. These are what? Hydrocarbons. Propane, butane. These are hydrocarbons. Okay. This is the mixture of methane, propane and butane. Okay, these things are mainly methane is present, and propane and butane, they are present in small proportions. Okay, these two are present in small proportion. It can be easily transported through pipes and is a clean non-polluting fuel. Non-polluting fuel. Okay, and it is stored under high pressure, then we call it compressed natural gas, CNG. And this is very useful, all you know. CNG is used for power generation. It is also used for being as non-polluting fuel for vehicles. Natural gas is used as starting material for the manufacture of a number of chemicals and fertilizers. After this, children, we will discuss energy and technological development. Energy and technological development. Okay. As we know, we need more energy. We need more energy to run new factories and to power the new gadgets and gadgets made by the use of the new technologies. Like nowadays, we can see our laptop, mobile, TV, fridge, all these are new gadgets. They all require large amount of energy. So manufacturing and using these also, okay, these billions of computers, these things and computer uses a huge amount of electrical energy. Some areas in which energy consumption has increased several times, we are going to discuss those areas. First is manufacturing goods in factories uses a huge amount of energy. Second, in agriculture, energy is needed for running tube wells, tractors and other machines. Next is food processing and storage of food in cold storage houses uses a huge amount of energy. Next is means of transportation require large amount of energy in the form of fuels or electricity. And we use much more energy at home today due to the increased number of electrical gadgets in homes such as refrigerator, air conditioner, washing machine, etc. So children, we require too much of energy. So how we can prevent this energy? Ultimately what? Energy crisis is there and all you know, like load shedding takes place. How we prevent this energy crisis? By judicious use. Okay. By judicious use of, by using energy judiciously, we can overcome energy crisis. How we can use judiciously the things? First is switching off light, fan, etc., which are not in use. Second, reducing the flame by cooking when the water starts boiling to save fuel. Next, use CFLs and tube lights or LEDs in place of bulbs. Using public transport instead of private vehicle as much as possible. Walking or cycling along small distances. Using pressure cookers for cooking. Using efficient smokeless chulas in houses instead of kerosene, coal or wood for cooking. Reducing cooking time by soaking pulses for some time before cooking and keeping vessels covered with while cooking. So these are the ways we can prevent, like we can use energy judiciously and prevent energy crisis. Okay, what are the advantages of using energy judiciously? It will delay the energy crisis and it will give our scientists more time to develop more efficient alternate sources of energy. Now next is children, conservation of fossil fuel, very important. Conservation of fossil fuel. India produces only about 30% of the petroleum that we need. Rest we import from the other countries. The exhaustible resources like coal and petroleum will be finished soon if we do not manage them properly. Alternative sources of energy such as solar, wind and biomass should be used in place of fossil fuels. Biogas is a cheap and convenient fuel for our rural population. It is produced from waste products like human waste, cattle dung, garbage, etc. So effective use of biomass to derive many products of industrial and commercial importance has increased with the progress in biotechnology. So children, we have to think about this. We have to conserve our fossil fuel because our next generation, what will they find if we are going to consume this thing? Okay, children?